Good morning, brothers and sisters. Greetings in the wonderful name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. I want you to excuse my voice this morning. We had such a tremendous time yesterday with Pastor David Dupree in his church. I ministered, and we also had the privilege to take Brother Babe's children to the gravesite in Port Elizabeth, and we also had a wonderful time at the gravesite with those children. My request this morning is that you continue praying for those children. Just make sure that you spend time, amen, to pray for Robina and Georgie and Kaini. These children, they need your prayers and your support, my brothers and sisters. Let's read the word and let's completely this next few days dedicate our lives to the Almighty God, and we trust the Lord for an outpouring of His presence. Ons vertrou die Here vir 'n bonatuurlike beweging van die Heilige Gees hierdie week. Whatever you need, I want to request that wherever you are this morning, just slip up your hand. Amen. Just lay your hand upon your wife, upon your children, upon a neighbor, a colleague in your office. Just stretch out a hand towards one another, and we want to commit all your needs and your heart's desires. We want to put it all this morning into the hands of the Almighty God. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, in the beautiful name of Jesus Christ, Father, we want to thank you this morning for allowing us to have this little devotion. We want to thank you for each one that are tuning in and that are receiving this little clip and sending it to their friends and to their loved ones. Father, Lord God, we want to pray for every believer. Lord, some have lifted up their hands. Some have stretched out their hands towards a neighbor. And this morning, Father, we want to pray a prayer of faith. And we want to pronounce the blessings of the Lord upon their lives. May you touch them this morning. And whatever they need this morning, may they believe, because you have promised that whatsoever we ask in your name, and if we believe, you shall give it to us. Father, we pray as we believe this morning that we will receive it, O God, in the mighty name of the Almighty God. Ons sê vir u baie dankie vir oggend, Here. Amen and amen. We want to draw your attention for the next few days on a very, very, very important subject. And I'm trusting the Lord as the days develop that we will just hear more from the Lord, and that more and more, amen, hallelujah, we will open up our hearts for the preaching of the word. I wonder, can we read together in the book of Psalms, chapter 31? You can also just underline this other verses also. We will pick it up in the next few days in the book of 2 Peter 1 verse 3. And then you read a few verses in that one. And also Job 19 verse 23 until verse 27. These are also the scriptures that we will pick up in the next few days. Psalms chapter 31. Let's read only one verse. My times are in thy hand. Deliver me from the hand of my enemies and from them that persecuted me. Do you follow that this morning, my brothers and sisters? The Bible says that our times is in the hands of the Almighty God. We cannot decide, amen, hallelujah, when we want to go and when we want to leave the earth. The Bible says that our times, amen, are in the hands of the Almighty God. Nothing can happen with us until the plan and the work of God is finished in our life. Allow me to read a few quotes, amen, as we're just going to build on this text for the next few days. We would like to speak on God's divine arrangement. God's divine arrangement. And we want to just draw your attention this morning, amen, that this arrangement, this appointment that God has arranged, it is not just any appointment. It's not an appointment like you can have today on this Monday morning with a client or a visitor. No, the appointment, the arrangement that we are talking about here, it is a divine arrangement. Amen, hallelujah. And what does the word divine means? It means, amen, it's related, amen, to a proceeding, amen, that is directly from God. So this divine, amen, arrangement, amen, it is a proceeding, amen, directly from the throne of God. And that's why you will hear many times when people pray and when things are, especially when things are getting tough, you will also hear people will say, Lord, I need your divine intervention. And what does that mean? It means that this is a serious matter. Amen. And it is a matter of urgency. Amen. Sometimes we pray because we know how to pray. But sometimes when trouble is really heavy and things are out of hand, you will always hear people will now be very much serious and they would say, Lord, we need a divine intervention. So what does that mean this morning, my brother and sister? That means now that the person that are praying now, they need, amen, a supernatural move by the Almighty God. My precious brother and sister, I want to just encourage you for the next few days. Ons wil vir julle bemoedig. Daar is so baie families wat vanmôre, amen, julle weet nie watter kant toe om te gaan en watter besluit is om te neem nie. We're going to pray this week for a divine intervention from the throne of the Almighty God. Amen. Maybe you are just on the brink. You are just on the brink to quit or to commit suicide or to take your own life and may try to make an end because of your troubles and because of your situations that is so heavy and that you are experiencing such a lot of trouble at the moment. We're going to pray this week for a godly intervention, a divine intervention from the Almighty God. Allow me to read one or two verses. And I think that this is a wonderful time to think on the hopes that God has given us. Now we want to draw this first into your mind. We want to draw your attention this next few days on this very important notes. Amen. That there is not one thing that can destroy us until the purpose of God, amen, who created us, has been fulfilled. There is nothing. And if the word of God says there is nothing, then it means there is nothing, amen, hallelujah, that can destroy the purpose of God, amen, until God is finished with us. Let me continue to read. Amen. Until the purpose of He who created us has been fulfilled, there could be nothing. We are made for a purpose. God has made you. God has made me, your wife, your husband. Amen. Your children is here today. God has made each one of us with a purpose. We are not here without a purpose. Let's continue. This church, your church that you are serving in, was built for a purpose. This foundation was not dig and the cornerstone laid and the blocks laid into the building and the roof, and the interior was not put here just to see if it could be done. It was put here by a purpose, or for a purpose. Your home, my brother, that you are living in, no matter how small the RDP house is, or how small that little gully is, that you are staying with your family, your home that you live in was not just accidentally put there. Was not just accidentally put there, or somebody just wasting some time. Your home was made for a purpose, to serve a purpose. And you, my brother and sister, I want to just underline this, and I would like to continue with it tomorrow morning. Remember, you have been created by God with a purpose. You are not here out of a purpose. And I want to just underline and want to draw your attention to this very, very serious matter. God has not used wasted material to build you or to form you or to place you today. God has not used scrap metal. God has not used off-cut material, amen, to put you together. God has not wasted, amen, hallelujah. God has not taken wasted material to put you together, my brother and sister. You are created in the image and in the likeness of the Almighty God. And I want to encourage you this morning, don't let anybody tell you that God has wasted His time in creating you this morning. Sometimes when things is tough and trouble is raging, then the devil will tell us that God has wasted His time creating us. And sometimes we, when trouble and situations are so heavy, then you feel that you have no purpose on this earth. Amen. Hallelujah. Don't allow the devil to tell you that your life, that you, my sister, that you, my brother, that you, young boy, that you doesn't have an important purpose in the plan of the Almighty God. Jy het 'n belangrike rol vir môre wat jy gaan speel in die koninkryk van God. And this next few days, we're going to speak a lot about your purpose. Not about your neighbor's purpose, but the purpose that God has created you, my sister, you, my brother, and what the plan of God is for you, because you have a divine arrangement. God made a divine arrangement. arrangement to create you in his own likeness. Amen. Even your car that you drive, amen, this morning, hallelujah, was not just made to see if it could work. The materials was not wasted by man. The car that you drive, no matter how cheap your car was, the people that built that car did not construct that car out of wasted material. They took the best material they could ever use to construct and put that car that you're driving now today, because that car was constructed and built for a purpose. Amen. It was put here for a purpose and to serve that purpose. When you turn the key of your car, it is there to serve a purpose. And you, my brother, and you, my sister, this morning, has been created in the likeness of God to fulfill a very important purpose in this world. Let us pray. We trust God to continue tomorrow morning. Father, as we follow the leading of your Holy Ghost, this week we will speak on a very important subject: finding the purpose of God in our lives. Lord Jesus, you have a divine arrangement, that you made to be with us today. Thank you for your word. Bless us and undertake for us this next few days. In Jesus' name, amen.